Good morning student, myself Pankaj Kumar and welcome to my class. Today we are going to start chapter 6 Roman numeral. So let's start. We usually write the numbers using the Hindu Arabic system which uses the 10 digits 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9 and using these digits we can write any number like 265, 331, 1000 etc. Okay. The number can also be written in Roman numeral. The number can also be written in Roman numeral. Using Roman numeral also we can write any number. Okay. And it is one of the oldest numeral system. Okay. Our early people use this Roman numeral. Okay. Now, all numbers can be written using 7 Roman numerals. So, here we have 7 Roman numerals. Using this we can write any number. Clear to you? Let me explain you. So here we have the symbol and the where and their values. Okay. So first symbol we have I and the value of this I is 1. Okay. Second symbol we have V and the value of this V is 5. Okay. Then we have X and the value of this X is 10. Then L and the value of this L is 50. Then we have C and the value of this C is 100. Then we have D and the value of D is 500. Clear? Then we have M and the value of M is 1000. So this you have to learn. Using this symbol we have to write, we can write any number. Okay? So this chart you have to learn the symbol and their values. Clear to you? So we have 7 symbol here which you have to learn. Now let me move to the next slide. Now we are going to discuss the rules to write and read the Roman numerals. Okay, so we have 3 rules: rule of repetition, rule of addition, then rule of subtraction. Let me discuss one by one. So rule number 1, rule of repetition. Okay, and we have point number 1, when a symbol is repeated twice that means 2 times or thrice that means 3 times, its value is multiplied by 2 or 3 respectively. Now see the example and try to understand the concept. Okay, so here you can see we have used the symbol M and the value of this symbol M is 1000. Clear? The value of symbol M is 1000. And here you can see in this box I have used the symbol M how many times? 2 times. 1, 2. Okay. And the value of M you know very well, 1000. So here I have written 2 times. So value of M is going to multiply by 2. Okay. So value of M 1000 and this will be multiplied by 2. Because I have used here M how many times? 2 times. Okay. Same way here you can see M I have used 3 time, so value of M will be multiplied by 3. Okay, as you can see 1000 into 3 equal to 3000. Okay, so this is point number 1. Now point number 2, symbol I, X, C and M can be repeated 3 time at maximum. 3 time at maximum, that means I, X, C and M we can repeat maximum 3 times, not more than that. Now see the example. For 1 we can write 1i, 2 we can write 2i, for 3 we can write 3i, but for 4 we cannot write 4i. Okay, we cannot repeat the symbol 4 times. Clear to you? Symbol I we cannot repeat more than 3 times. Clear? Here you can see it is mentioned here symbol I, X, C and M can be repeated 3 times maximum, not more than that. Okay, so this is wrong. Here I am repeating how many times? 4 times. Clear to you? Now point number 3, symbol V, L and D are never repeated. Now this symbol cannot be repeated. Clear? V, L and D. Now see the example and you try to understand the concept. So here you can see, suppose you have to write 10. Okay, as you have seen here for 3 I have used here how many I, 3i. Same way for 10 also we can write 2i according to this point number 2. So value of v you know very well, 5, and value of v 5. Okay, 5 plus 5, 10. This can be, but this is wrong. Why? Because it is mentioned in point number 3. Symbol v, l and d are never repeated. V we cannot repeat. Okay, v we cannot repeat. Same way 400 ll can be written, but this is wrong. Okay, l we cannot repeat. Clear to you? L we cannot repeat as it is mentioned in point number 3. Okay, the value of l you know very well, 50. So 50 plus 50 according to this ll, 50 plus 50. Okay, but this is wrong. We cannot repeat symbol v. Okay, instead of this we can write 410. So we have separate symbol for 10 here, you can see in the chart, and we have separate symbol for l also. 50, l also here you can see 50, sorry, 400 we have c. Okay, so instead of these we can write x for 10, c for 100. Okay, now rule of addition. This is rule number 2, rule of addition. If a symbol of a smaller value is written to the right of a symbol of higher value, we add the smaller value to the greater value. Okay, if a smaller value symbol is written just right of higher value symbol, in that case we have to add smaller value symbol with higher value symbol. Okay, example you can see here and you try to understand. So you can see here we have x I and left side we have higher value symbol, that means the value of this x we have 10 and the value of I we have 1. Okay, so clearly you can see smaller value symbol is written just right side of the higher value symbol. In that case what we have to do, we have to add the higher value symbol with, sorry, we have to add the smaller value symbol with greater value symbol. Okay, that means here we will get 10 plus 1 11. Okay, 10 plus 1 11. Why? Because smaller value symbol is written right side of the higher value symbol. Okay, so 10 is the value of x and 1 is the value of I. So we'll add 10 plus 1, we'll get 11. Same way here you can see the value of v is 5 and the value of x is 10. Okay, and the smaller value symbol is written just right side of the higher value symbol. So in this case what we have to do, we have to add the smaller value symbol with higher value symbol. Okay, so when we add 10 plus 5, so here we will get 50. Okay, so this is the value of xb and 11 is the value of xi. Clear? Now rule number 3, rule of subtraction. So here we have point number 1, if a symbol of a smaller value is to the left of symbol of higher value, we subtract the smaller value from the higher value. So if symbol of a smaller value is written just left side of the higher value symbol, in that case what we have to do, we have to subtract smaller value symbol from higher value symbol. Okay, so example here you can see, so here we have I v and the value of v is 5 and value of I is 1. Okay, value of I is 1. So you can see the smaller value symbol is written just left side of the higher value symbol. So in this case what we have to do, we have to subtract smaller value symbol from higher value symbol. Okay, so when we subtract, 5 minus 1 will get 4. Okay, that means the value of IV is 4. Clear? See this example also, the value of x 10 and the value of c 100, value of c 100. Now clearly you can see x is smaller value symbol and c is greater value symbol, and x is written just left side of higher value symbol. So in this case, what we have to do, we have to subtract this 10 from 100. Okay, so when we subtract 100 minus 10, we will get 90. Okay, so this is the value of xc. 90 is the value of xc. Clear to you? Then point number 2, the symbol v l d cannot be subtracted from any number. So this symbol cannot be subtracted from any number. Here we have seen, if the smaller value symbol is written left side of higher value symbol, in that case we have to subtract, but this symbol we cannot subtract, v, l and d. Okay, see the example. We have 95. According to this point number 1, we can write like this: v c, the value of c 100, and value of v 5. Okay, so according to this point number 1, we can subtract 5 from 100, then we will get 95. But this is wrong, because this symbol is mentioned in this point number 2, the symbol v, l and d cannot be subtracted from any number. That's why this is wrong. So how you will write this one, 95, in Roman numeral? So for that, what you have to do, first we will write 100, xc, then v. Okay, the value of c you know very well, 100, and if we write x just left side of this symbol, then the value of x you know very well, 10 will be subtracted from the value of c. Okay, so from here we will get what, 90. So when we write xc, then we will get 90, and then we have to add what, 5 to get 95, then we will give here v. Clear? Xcv. Okay, this is the correct Roman numeral for 95. Clear to you? Now point number 3, symbol I, x and c are used to subtract. So wherever you see this symbol, there will be subtraction. Okay, these are used to subtract. So there are just 6 combinations. Now let me show you one by one. So here we have I, V, and the value of V, 5, and value of I, 1. So there will be subtraction. So 5 minus 1, 4. That means IV, value of IV, 4. Then come to this box. The value of X is 10 and the value of L is 50. Okay. So 50 minus 10, 40. X is a smaller value symbol and L is higher value symbol. Okay. Now D. D is higher value symbol. The value of D is 500 and C is smaller value symbol, and the value of C is 100, and it is mentioned in the point number 3, I, X, C are used to subtract. That means wherever is I, X and C, there will be subtraction. Okay, from the higher value symbol. Okay, so we have D here and the value of D 500, and the value of C is 100, so 100 will be subtracted from 500, then we will get 400. Okay, so 400 is the value of CD. Same way, I x, value of x 10 and value of I 1. When we subtract, we will get 9. So this is the value of I x. Here the value of c 100 and value of x 1. Okay, when we subtract, we will get 90. This is the value of x c. Clear to you? Now here cm, the value of m 1000 and value of c 100. When we subtract, we'll get 900. Okay, we'll get 900. Clear to you? So 900 is the value of cm. Okay. Now this is rule number 4. If bar is placed over a numeral, then it is multiplied by 1000. If bar is placed over the numeral, so here you can see the numeral, and the value of this numeral is 5, and bar is placed just over the numeral. okay, and the in other word we can say the value of this bar is 1000, okay, and this value of this bar will be multiplied by the value of this symbol, okay. So value of this symbol we have 5, and this will be multiplied by value of this bar. So we can use here 1000, then we'll get 5000, okay, then we'll get 5000. Clear? That is only mentioned here. If bar is placed over the numeral, then it is multiplied by 1000, okay. See the next example. So we have the numeral here, symbol here x, and the value of this x is 10, okay. So this will be multiplied by 1000, okay. Why? Because bar is placed over the symbol, okay. Bar is placed over the symbol, and for this bar we have to use 1000. Clear? That means the value of x will be multiplied by 1000. When we multiply, we'll get 10,000. Clear to you? Now this is rule number 4. Now let me solve some question and you try to understand the concept. Write the following in Roman numeral. So here we have some question, and this we have to write in Roman numeral. Okay, so we have 198. So first what you have to do, you have to write this in expanded form, and you know very well how to expand. So when you expand, you'll get here 100 plus 90 plus 8. Okay, now write Roman numeral for each number. So first we have 100, and we have separate symbol for 100, C. Now now you have to write 90. Now how will write 90? How will write 90? First you write 100, and you know very well. First you write 100, and the Roman numeral for 100 is C. Then you subtract 10. Then you subtract 10. Okay. Just write here x. Okay. Now you can see x is a smaller value symbol and c is higher value symbol. So easily you can subtract the value of x from value of c. Okay. So value of c 100, and you have to subtract the value of x, which is 10. Okay. When you subtract, you will get 90. So xc we can write. Okay. Clear to you? So for 90 we got here xc. Now we have to write 8. Okay, now we have to write 8. So 8 we can write first v, and the value of this v is 5. Then we have to add 3, then write here 1 2 3, 3 times I. So this is what, this is 3, 5 plus 3. Okay, 5 6 7 8. So this can be v I. Okay, so this is the Roman numeral for 8. Clear to you? When we combine, then you will get here C X C V I. Sorry, 3 times I. C X C V I. This is the answer for 198. Okay, Roman numeral for 198. Now let me give you one more example. Here we have 3511. As I told you, first you have to write in expanded form. When we expand, we'll get here 3510 plus 1. Okay, for 3000, first you write 3, then give bar over the numeral. Okay, this is 3, and here I have given bar. That means this 3 will be multiplied by 1000. Okay, then only you will get the 3000. Okay, so this is numeral for Roman numeral for 3000. Now we have separate symbol for 500, which is D. Okay, for 10 also we have separate symbol X. For 1 also we have separate symbol. Okay, so when we combine, we'll get I bar over 3 D X I. Okay, D X I bar over I, then D, X, I. This is the Roman numeral for 3511. ओके. सो चिल्ड्रेन, टुडे व्हाटएवर आई हैव डिस्कस विथ यू, आई होप इच एंड एवरीथिंग इज क्लियर टू यू. थैंक यू.